Subscribe to Asianet Newsable's YouTube channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update from us.
Karnataka Lokayukta stabbed at least 5 times right in his office around 1:30 p.m. yesterday. And this has sent shockwaves among even the advocates in these offices, along with armed janta like you and me. Reports say that the accused Tej Raj Sharma had approached the Lokayukta several times for a personal grievance of his regarding a tender and has claimed that this is an act of pent-up anger. The question then boils down to how effective is this Lokayukta? Yes, much has been said about the loopholes in security with metal detectors and CCTV cameras adorning the office serving no concrete purpose. But what is to be noted is that the government conveniently ignored the requests sent to up the security measures. Not once, not twice, 20 times.
Security ha jaasti maadi ant heli 20 kaagda baddidare 20 kaagdal ond kaagdakku idu varigu sarkaradin reply illavante.
What's wrong here? There are many more facts to prove that Lokayukta is indeed a toothless organization. For the government, first tried to take the power of grievance redressal from the Lokayukta. Well, that wasn't successful. But the Congress government later usurped the power of investigating corruption cases by forming the Anti-Corruption Bureau. Perhaps to avert a situation like what happened when the anti-corruption crusader, like former Lokayukta Santosh Hegde, who was instrumental in taking up the mining case, pinning down then Chief Minister B.S. Yediyurappa of the BJP.
I've seen an effort from the people who are in power, it could be political power, it could be administrative power, to see that the institution of Lokayukta, if not closed, to disable it from making proper inquiry or make it a very weak institution which will not cause any harm to people in power.
When ACB is under the Home Minister, one can understand how those in power will be dealt with if found allegedly corrupt. When elections are around the corner, one can't help but observe the timing of this incident. In a span of 20 odd days after the Nalapad attack on Vidwat in Bengaluru's UB city, this incident comes to fore. Congress MLA N.A. Harris's son, Nalapad, is still in central jail fighting for bail in the alleged case of Gundaism. Now, this attack gives the opposition parties like BJP and JDS enough ammunition.
This is the side of Vidhan Sauda. Just not a 1 feet away from Vidhan Sauda.
Now, BJP's Ashok has raised interesting point. This institution is just 3 buildings away from the Grand Vidhana Sauda, which is the Secretariat of Karnataka. Would the government be as lethargic in responding with respect to the security there?